Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Sachi Basin Daga. So if you're new here, welcome to my little home here on YouTube. So for today's video, I am so excited. I'm doing a full face of PAC Cosmetics. It's actually like a full face plus first impression because they've sent me so many new products. So shout out to PAC Cosmetics. Thank you so much. And I actually have no idea how these will look on my skin, how they test, how they perform. I'm really, really excited. Of course, they're not all products in the sense like not all face products that are new. I have a couple which I'm going to be using as well. But without further ado, let's just get started. They sent me so many new things. Their pack brushes are amazing. They've sent me these four brushes right here, which I am so excited to use. I literally use so many of their brushes that I keep ordering on Nykaa, so I'm really excited to use these. These three are primarily eyeshadow brushes, so we're gonna test these out today. So we're gonna use this primer which they've sent us, and they've also sent this lightweight rejuvenating lotion. So we're gonna try these two out. Again, brand new products. They also sent their foundation. It really comes in this little tube right here. It's so luxe. Like, the whole feeling to this is really nice. It's very, very sturdy. It's their HD liquid foundation, and they've sent me two of them. I've unboxed it because I think in the shipping process it kind of leaked a bit, so I've unboxed it, and they've sent me these two shades. We're gonna see which one works. I've never used this foundation before, so I'm really excited to see how this performs and lasts. They've sent me this one, which is 1.2. This seems like a very fair option for me. And the other one that they've sent me is 1.7. They have also sent their Dusk to Dawn eyeshadow palette. This is a shimmer eyeshadow palette, which is absolutely perfect for the summer. So let's open it up and see what we have in store. It looks like, guys, this is so pretty. I mean, there's a ton of product that you get, and you get almost like every kind of shimmer shadow that you primarily need. I mean, it's just like a very huge travel friendly thing. So this is going on our eyes today. Then of course they've sent us two blushes, which I'm really excited about. I really desperately needed a new blush, and I'm excited to open this up and see which one is going on my face today. What the product looks like. I'm going to be giving product details as and when we go and do like the application shots, etc. Oh my god, this is so pretty. This is absolutely stunning. This is like a muted coral peachy shade, which I think is absolutely perfect. And I love the quantity, like it feels really sturdy and on the go. Like that's what I love about this. 009, which was a beautiful mute corally shade. And we have 018, which is a little brighter. I don't know if you can make out. I'm gonna try both of these on like each cheek basically and see how these perform. But when I'm looking at it, I don't know whether you guys can see it, but it's very similar, just that 018 is slightly brighter. Yeah, okay, we're gonna check this out. We have to really like test this thing, put this in the test. So two new blushes. Then we have their baked highlighter. Okay, so I've used the one in BK, I think it was 11, I don't remember, but this is BK 13. This is Bling Affair, and this is what it looks like. Again, it is a very sturdy packaging and comes with this huge mirror right here, and you get this beautiful highlight shade, which I'm really, really excited to try on today. I have another one which I absolutely love, but I'm going to put this shade to the test today. So another highlighter. Then we have a mascara by the brand, which again I'm really excited about. I haven't tried out their mascaras yet. This looks nice. It's called the No Worries Mascara. So this is what it looks like. Again, putting this to the test today, and let's see what else. Okay, nothing else. So in terms of the lipstick, in terms of the eyeliner, in terms of you know, the skin corrector, that I'm just going to be using my own products, which, you know, constitutes the entire full face. So besides that, we have a lot of products to test out from PAC. So let's get started. I'm going to start off with the lightweight rejuvenating lotion by PAC Cosmetics. This is a 100 ml product, and it is for $7.95. What this helps to do is it helps in pore refinement, it replenishes lipids, and it helps in cellular regeneration. So that's a lot of promise from this. Let's open it up and see how the product looks inside. Oh, so it's a very chic looking product. It's absolutely matte black, and again, very sturdy to carry, and I feel, okay, seems pretty watery, like the noise is watery, okay, and open this up. Okay, so it looks like a spray, if you can see. Comes like this spray format, so let's see how this bombs. What? It's not, it's a spray lotion? What? Okay, what? Okay, what? One second. So, okay, this is a lotion. It's a rejuvenating lotion, but it's in a spray form, which is absolutely exciting. Okay, let's just apply it to the face and see what happens. Oh my god, this actually feels really hydrating, but I feel like you need to go in with a moisturizer if you like a tacky feel, but no, this is pretty tacky actually. Feels really nice. Okay, I did not expect that it feels really refreshing. I feel awake for this video right now. That's very interesting, not expected. We're gonna go ahead and check out the oil control primer now. This is again paraben free, it's mineralized, and this is priced at 835 rupees. What this helps to do is open it up and see what is written inside. Okay, that is beautiful. That is stunning. Look at that. Like, I mean, this is so beautiful. Like, I just want to keep this on my table and stare at it. Isn't that stunning looking primer? I've never seen anything like this. That is so beautiful. Okay, so this is the oil control primer by PAC. And this is a 30 ml primer, so that is really cool. This is travel friendly, you guys. It has these gold specks inside this, so I don't know how this is going to show up on the skin. I hope it's not like too chunky or anything, because you know, you just want like a smooth surface to work on. But let's test it on our hand. Okay, so this is what the texture feels like, looks like, and it feels very hydrating and smooth. Oh my god, that blended like a dream, guys. And you cannot see the golden flecks. It's very minimal, it's like barely there, so that's a very good thing. And immediately my hand looked much smoother. This is the one, this is the hand I put it on. Okay, I'm gonna put this on the face. I'm so excited if we have like an affordable primer, because this is, how much is this for? $8.35. That is not bad at all, like at all, for such a luxe looking. Oh, I'm so excited. It's on the face again. I'm taking a pump on my finger and on my eye. I need some more. This feels so good. You know, it's reminding me of, I want to say, a very high-end brand name, and being able to place it. It's just sunk into my skin. Like, I feel like I barely applied it and it's just sunk in. Like, I don't feel like I have anything on my skin. So this is an oil control primer, so it's going to be amazing for summer. I'm putting this on the lids also, so let's see how this makes the makeup last. Skin feels really smooth and nice. I'm so excited. And now we're gonna head on to the main thing, which is the foundation, which I'm really excited about. Like, all, so a lot of my makeup artists also have used it on me, but I don't really remember much about it, so I'm excited to test it out. Like I said, we have two shades right here, and we don't have a concealer as well, which they sent me over, which I loved. Let me quickly get that as well. Okay guys, so now we're heading on to foundation. Again, I am super excited to try these out. So a lot of makeup artists have used this on my skin, but I honestly don't remember how it felt. And this is the first time I'm actually feeling the component. It's a glass component. Gives a very luxe vibe. You get 30 ml of product, and this is priced at $8.75. So this is for $8.75. So before I go ahead and put the foundation on my skin, I want to go ahead and color correct. I'm just using my own color corrector, which again, you guys know the Nykaa Skin Genius Correct and Conceal Palette. So I'm just going ahead and using the orange color corrector and placing it under my eyes. Okay, this applies so easily above this primer. This primer is really nice. Like whatever I'm feeling as of now, I'm liking it. Okay, so we've got our touch of color correction done. Now let's go ahead and use the foundation. For concealer, I have again the pack Spotlight Concealer. They had sent me a while back when, you know, they just launched it. So I have used this out and I really like this concealer. So I'm going to be using this over this and also seeing how that works. So I'm going to pump these two on my hand. I'm going to see which one really works best. Okay, so this comes with this little kind of a cap, if you can see. Take it out and I'm going to pump this in the back of my hand. Tie off with this one. So I've just unlocked it and I'm going to put one pump. Okay, so this is 1.2. Doesn't seem too bad, and I'm gonna try now for 1.7. It's a little difficult. I really need to check it out. I don't know. I'm just taking my ColourPop F16 brush and I'm just gonna see which one works better. Honestly, I think I'm a mix of these two, so I'm gonna mix these two shades up and try it out. Okay, that is perfect for my skin tone. I think I just have to mix in the 1.7 a little bit more just to give a slight amount of warmth to the skin, because this seems like it's a very fair shade, but I think we can work with it. I'm just going ahead with whatever's the back of my hand. Again, this is 1.2 and 1.7. Take a little bit more of these two shades and work it into my skin. Okay, so usually for my foundation, I always use this pack brush. This is pack 005 brush. I tend to really enjoy this brush. But for this particular foundation, I just want to really slowly build it up, because this is more of a buffing into the skin brush. So now I'm going to go ahead and just blend it into my skin further. I haven't put anything on my forehead. I'm just gonna put a little bit more for some more coverage. So I'm really liking the finish of this foundation. It's not a matte finish. Like, I don't find it like mattifying as such, because I can still see my skin peeking through and it still looks pretty luminous that way. It's not gonna dewy finish in the sense, not slippy. So I would say it's a medium to full coverage. It can definitely build up like we've seen. And it's a satin finish. Like, that's what I would describe this foundation as. Okay, let's go ahead and put the concealer on. So I think this is the Spotlight Ready Liquid Concealer, which is full coverage and waterproof, and this is in the shade Sand. I'm gonna place this. So I feel this is a little bit too warm for this particular foundation as of now, but it's okay, we can blend it out and we can see what happens. So for this, I'm going to go ahead and use the Spotlight Concealer brush, which is the hashtag SL02 pack brush. This is what they've sent me again earlier, so I'm going to go ahead and buff this into my under eye area. I think I'm just going to put a little bit of that Fair 1.2 as my concealer as well. Let's see if that works, because as of now I'm finding this way too warm. It is a stunning concealer. Like, I definitely use it very often. It's just that for this particular look, I don't think it's going that well. So again, I'm going to use now my PAC 005 brush and I'm just going to blend that in. Guys, let's move forward. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to quickly finish my brows off camera. I'm going to be using my favorite brow brush, and this is again by PAC, the 100 brush. I absolutely love this for the brows, and I'm going to go ahead and use my ColourPop brow pot and I'll be right back. That is our brows, so let's move on to the eyes. Now for this we have our eyeshadow palette, which is the Dusk to Dawn PAC Cosmetics Shimmer Eyeshadow Palette. Again, this is absolutely stunning. We have 7 beautiful shades right here. You get like this beautiful champagne, you get like a very dull gold right here. It's like a more greenish based gold. Then you have like a subtle, like a gold highlight shade. You get a popping rose gold coral shade. You get a beautiful pink bright shade. Then you get like a greenish shade, like a military green shade, I would say. It's a very unique color. And then you get this midnight beautiful shimmery shadow. Actually, since it's a totally shimmer shadow, I just want to use maybe like a contour shade just to get some transition, some depth into my eye. So I'm going to go ahead with any contour shade. You can use like any like normal bronzy color. So I'm just going to go ahead and use the House of Mirrors duo set, and this is by ColourPop, and I'm just going to use this color right here just to add some dimension. So now that we're going on with our eyes, we can also use and test out these brushes right here. This is by, of course, PAC Cosmetics. I'm going to go ahead and use the PAC 041 brush for the eye, and I'm just going to zoom you guys in. So we've zoomed in, let's go ahead and finish the eyes. So I'm just going to use the ColourPop House of Mirrors face duo. This is really exciting for me because I'm so obsessed with eyeshadows at the moment, and to have like a good shimmer eyeshadow palette, you will be totally sorted. So I'm just going ahead and using the PAC 041 brush. This is what it looks like. I think it's absolutely perfect for your transition shade, and I'm really excited to test this out. So right off the bat, this is a really nice eyeshadow brush. I feel it blends the eyeshadow like a dream. Like, it's so effortless to do like a transition with this shade because it's very concise, but yet it's fluffy enough to move, you know, like effortlessly. So it's a very minimal bronze look because this is a very light bronze. This is what I'm going to use on my face today as well because I don't have a PAC bronzer as of now, so I'm going to use this. So I'm also going to try contouring my nose with this because this seems like a very precise brush. So let's go ahead and try. I knew it, it's just perfect. Okay, this is a great nose contour brush as well. Like, I really like this for a nose contour. Like, it's really precise and it just gives like the most effortless look. Like, it's just so easy to use this brush. Then we have 3 other brushes. I am going to go ahead and use this one. This is the PAC 114 brush. Again, this is a little bit, I would say, a little more densely packed and a little more smaller than the other brush. So I think this brush would be absolutely amazing to pack on some deeper shades and use it at your outer corner. So right here I have the Just My Luck. This is again from ColourPop. I'm so sorry guys, I don't have matte shadows in this shimmer shadow shade, so I just want to get some depth so that we can just apply the shimmer and see how it blends. So I'm just going ahead to show you how we can use this brush. I'm going to go ahead with this little brownish olive shade right here and I'm going to pack it on towards the outer corner. This is absolutely perfect to pack on colors. for your outer corner and just to keep building your look up. Just see how beautifully it does that, and it just takes the right amount of product. It's not going to take too much of it, and that's what I love. So you can keep building it up to the amount that you want. So I really like that. I think this would be great to use even under the eyes. I'm gonna just try and use this little bit of that brown shade and pack it on underneath the eye. I really like how that performed. That was really nice. Okay, we're down to the last two. Now this is what I'm gonna be using to pack on the shimmer shadows. These two beautiful brushes, and we're gonna again go ahead into this stunning palette, which I'm absolutely excited about. I'm gonna try and use as many colors as I can. No promises, because I am just gonna try my best. Cool. So what I really wanna do is, I feel like what I'm wearing right now is kind of like a yellow base. So I think we can go ahead with this stunning color right here. Watch it on my hand, and oh my god, that is absolutely stunning. I'm gonna go ahead and use the pack 102 brush. I feel this is absolutely apt to really pack on the shade, because this is not gonna move, this is not gonna budge. It's like a very densely packed brush, and the shape also is just gonna fit into the crevices of your crease and just put it all over the lid. Like, that's what I feel about this. Ready, I feel like it's just taking the product beautifully. Just going to you guys, I have no words. I just have no words, because this applied magically. I am not joking, this applied magically. I think these two are meant to be together. And that applied so well. It's just like, it just worked like a dream. Like, that's all I can say. So we're gonna try and use some more products, or I mean some more shades, obviously. So let's go ahead and use this one to place it on the center of the lid to give a little more of a high shine effect. So we're gonna put this right on this particular brush, and we're just gonna place it the center. Come back. So I just got my all-nighter setting mist. This is like my go-to. I'm just going to put that color, that beautiful little bit of a champagne-y gold. It looks like so. I just want to place this in the middle of the lid, because I just want the extra pop, like, you know, like that halo effect. J-Lo, J-Lo. Why am I like? Let's do this, guys. Okay, it's definitely doing something now. Like, it is definitely showing. I have no idea whether this is showing on camera, but over here it's giving that little bit of that metallic effect in the middle, which looks really pretty. However, I feel I need to go with a lighter color for this to really show in pictures or show in the camera. Let me try and do this here. It's very subtle. It's very subtle, because these two tones are quite similar, so maybe I shouldn't be using this together, but still, we have to use some shadows to see how this really performs. Yeah, see, it is working. I'm liking this, guys. I'm liking this. Okay, let's go ahead and use this one. This, I'm actually thinking of applying this beautiful shade on the inner corner of my eye. This is a really pretty inner corner highlight, so I think I'm gonna just go ahead with that. But I just want to quickly just see if this looks, gives a little more dimension to this look. This definitely neutralizes it, but it's not doing much to halo it up. But I really like how the look is looking. Like, it's looking very glowy and goddessy types, if I can see. if I could say it. Go ahead and use the PAC 002 brush. This again is one of the brushes that they sent me, and I'm really excited because this is absolutely perfect to go into your inner corner. That's what I feel, and I think like a thick wing I think you can make with this, so that'll be really cool. But let's go ahead and use this shade right here, which I had said I wanted to use in my inner corner, and okay, that is stunning. That is so pretty. I love that. Can you see that? That is absolutely stunning. Like, I think that is one of the prettiest inner corner highlights I've ever used. I'm gonna use this a little bit under the brow bone. Okay, that is beautiful. Like, I'm not even joking. I love that. This is my favorite shimmer, like this shadow, like this is why I would repurchase this palette, because of this color right here. It is so pretty. Pair it with the same brush and go ahead into this beautiful midnight blue metallic shade and put that as my waterline color. It is really pretty, I won't lie, that is stunning. It's really versatile, like it just went to my inner corner like a dream. It really, you know, lines your waterline, very apt. Again, it's perfect for your brow bone. So this is a very good brush to invest in. It's the PAC 002 brush. I'm gonna link down everything below with the prices, so don't worry. Yeah, I love this. It's like, I think my eye is looking really, really nice. So we still have quite a few products to cover. No Worries Mascara, again by PAC Cosmetics. I've never tried this before. It is for 645 rupees and is this waterproof? Is this waterproof? Because I watch some romantic comedies and I cry quite a bit. So let me see. I don't know if this is waterproof. So I'm reading here what it is, but I'm gonna check online. But yeah, let's just see how the applicator is. Okay, so the brush is quite interesting. This is what the wand looks like. It's got a little bit of a curve right here, like a slight curve if you guys can see. So I think it's perfect for really getting into your lashes and rolling it around and perfect the lower lashes as well. But I'm excited. I really desperately need a new favorite mascara, because the one that I'm using is the BFF mascara from ColourPop. I would love to see it. This is amazing. That is really pretty. It's just a little more watery than expected. Like, I feel it's a little watery because I like my mascaras a little bit, not dried up, but a little more, I don't know, thicker in consistency. So it's a little less watery when you look at it immediately. But this is making my lashes look really pretty. Like, it's really separating them and giving that kind of volume and thickness. Okay, what I like about this, you can really go ahead and keep coating your lashes. It doesn't feel so thick in the sense that you can't keep going in and making it look fuller. So I really like that. You can keep going and coating your lashes and making it look fluffy. Get on with bronzing and blush and highlight. So I don't have a PAC bronzer yet, so I'm gonna go with my own. This is again the ColourPop one, which I was using for my eye. I'm just gonna go ahead and use my ColourPop F1 brush. I love this for my bronzing. I'm a very light look today because I'm just like, this a super light bronzer. I don't think they have this anymore in Colourpop, but they are very similar shades, so you can check it out. I decided to go ahead with the blush. These two blushes, I'm gonna try one on each cheek, okay guys? So let's go ahead and use 018 on this side and 009 on this side. So 018 on the right cheek. I'm gonna go ahead with my Nykaa powder brush. I use this one to, you know, use it as a blush brush because the other one's a little bit smaller. So I like big blush brushes. That makes sense. So I'm gonna dip into this. Ooh, that's pretty good. Ooh, okay. Ooh, I'm excited. I went really like I lost it with that, but that is really pretty. I'm gonna blend it a bit because I went crazy with that. But oh my god, that is really pretty. That's got like a very corally, pinky, peachy, like very beautiful blush. I think that's stunning for summer. So this is 018. And let's try 009. I'm not gonna go ahead with the same brush. Let me try this one. This is my Colourpop. There's no thing, but this is their, I think this is their blush brush as well. So go ahead with that. It's pretty. That's really pretty. I think 018, if you can see, is much brighter. Like, I feel that's a little bolder version of 009. Like 009 is very wearable, like every day throughout the year, I feel. And 018 is just like very, very pretty for like summer, I feel. Like, I feel obviously you can wear this, you can tone it down. Like, I went ham with that. But I feel this is more wearable like every day, so I really like this shade. This shade is stunning. Ah, I'm gonna go ahead and use the baked highlighter again. Stunning shade. This is the shade of very, very pretty. And it's very silky smooth. Like, it's really easy to swatch these products. All the products are very soft, very comfortable, very pigmented. So I really love that. I'm gonna go ahead with my favorite Wet n Wild P77 brush. I use this all the time for highlight. Ah, what? Oh my god, that is so stunning. You guys see how beautiful the highlight and the blush look together? Like, it just blended in like a dream. Like, I'm down to the last thing, which is lips. Now, these two products are my own. They didn't send me this. In the sense, they haven't sent me this with this. They sent this a little earlier. This, if you guys follow me on Instagram, you know I love this. This is the Retro Matte Gloss, and this is in 11 Souza, a stunning color. I'm going to just see whether this looks better or this one. This is their neutral lipstick, and this is in Brunch. This is a bit of a nude-ish color. I'm just gonna swatch more than we figure. We're gonna figure this out. So that is Brunch, the nudie one. And this is Souza. I feel Souza is gonna look a little better. Not that it's my favorite, but that is Souza and that is Brunch. I think I'm gonna go with Souza, guys. I love this color. Like, it's amazing. Satisfaction. Okay guys, that is the final look. I honestly loved all the products. I think they're just beautifully priced. They're very, very luxe. The feel, the primer was amazing. I think it really made the foundation look really nice and really is holding the makeup well, like whatever I am noticing as of now, I am really liking. I think my favorite out of the lot has to be, I love the foundation, like I love the way it's feeling right now. The highlighter for sure, the blush, and I would say the brushes. I think those are highly, highly recommend. The eyeshadow palette is really interesting. I think I just have to really work with this and understand it. I think the shimmers are stunning, but you definitely need another matte palette. You cannot just like work with this because you need some transition, you need some depth to be able to create this look. So I would definitely recommend that you check their other palettes out as well and get a matte shadow and then this, so that they both mix and create a beautiful eye look. I really like the mascara. I still don't know whether this is waterproof or smudge proof yet. So yeah guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope you all enjoy. Don't forget to like, subscribe and share this video, and I will see you in my next.